This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
This is Justine Green. The fairness and effectiveness of tax cuts announced by the government yesterday are being questioned by some of the UK's leading financial researchers and charities. The Institute for Fiscal Studies says most people will be paying more in tax at the end of this parliament than they were at the start, while the Resolution Foundation, which focuses on lower incomes, has claimed London and the South East will benefit disproportionately. The economist Gerard Lyons, who advises the Prime Minister, has defended the government's move, saying the income tax system already favours lower earners.
We thankfully have a very progressive tax system. So the more you earn, the more tax you pay. So the top 1% of income taxpayers probably pay about 30% of income tax. The top 10% of income taxpayers probably pay 50% of income tax. So naturally, if you cut income tax, those people who earn more will get more.
Large numbers of men are continuing to try to leave Russia after President Putin announced that 300,000 reservists would be called up to serve in Ukraine. Many flights have sold out and a six-mile queue has formed at the border with Georgia. This man, who didn't want to be named, can't afford to leave, but says he'd rather face the consequences than fight.
I've realised that although the government claimed that they will call just 300,000 people, it would be probably more, which means that most of my friends will either leave the country or they have to go to the army or they will have to go to prison. My position is quite clear. I'm not going to the front. I'd better go to the prison rather than fight for the regime.
Iranian state media are reporting that 35 people have been killed in protests sparked by the death of a woman in police custody. During an eighth night of unrest, large crowds clashed with riot police in several cities. The Home Secretary Suella Braverman has told police chiefs that common sense policing must take priority over diversity and inclusion initiatives. In a letter to chief constables in England and Wales, she said that crimes involving drugs, vehicle theft and vandalism aren't being treated seriously enough. Sir Elton John has performed at the White House at the invitation of President Biden and received the National Humanities Medal for his work with HIV charities. He declined previous invitations to play from Mr. Biden's predecessor Donald Trump. The performance was part of a celebration to honour nurses, teachers and emergency workers.
I've played in some places before that have been beautiful, but this is probably the icing on the cake. I don't know how to take a compliment very well, but It's wonderful to be here amongst so many people who have helped my AIDS Foundation and my heroes, the ones that work day to day on the front line. Teachers, nurses, everybody who's helped. They're the heroes to me.
The actress Louise Fletcher, best known for playing the cruel nurse in the 1975 film One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, has died at the age of 88. She won an Academy Award for her performance as Nurse Ratchet opposite Jack Nicholson. That's the BBC News. It's 3 minutes past 11.
Thank you, Justine.
On the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM. Cardia, Winkleman, BBC Radio 2.